Did you call Eminem and tell Eminem don't go back in Nick Cannon? Did y'all have a conversation?
I did.
What was that conversation like?
I was like, yo, ain't nothing there. Like, you know, because M, he'll get hype and go, what? Like, you said something like you challenging him in that way. Because he comes from that format, the battle format. Like, they actually put him in a space where he's the most comfortable when they him. You know what I'm saying? Because that's the, when they stand in front of you and well, you're the focus and topic. So they find things about you and do things, right? Creative things and put it together. Like, that's where he's comfortable.
He's giving me about 6 bars.
Yeah, he's good to go.
Yeah. Nick Cannon did that song, Used to Look Up to You, and he said that was about you.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know if you want that problem rapping with Nick Cannon.
I would never respond to Nick Cannon. Never. Listen up. Now, look, the camera's on, right? He's legendary corny. He's been corny forever, like from the very beginning. I thought at one point he was headed somewhere that was like in the Will Smith-ish kind of, because it was comedy stuff like that. And then it just never got to its destination. Like, it just never got cool. Like,
he's a good businessman, would you cast him
in a Power Book? Anyone
else? If he did a good job. Like, he did great in Drumline.
Drumline was dope.
Mm-hmm. He did good in that. Like, I believed him. As a drummer.
Okay. See, the thing with Nick, that Nick is a great businessman. The only thing that makes him look corny is his rapping.
Yeah, I don't know why he's so passionate about it. Like he's just, what the hell's going on? Bro, look, you suck, bro. I'm going to just tell you the truth. Like, there's never a moment where you said something and we was like, ooh, bars.
Have you ever spoken to Nick? I mean, I know you spoke to him in person, but I'm talking about since all of this stuff been going on.
No, I haven't. Like, I look at it like he's trying to build energy for a show, the talk show and the radio show stuff.
Right, because he wanted you to come on Wildin' Out.
Right.
And that was a perfect bait for that to happen.
Yeah, so I wouldn't like just talk to him, because I know what that is. I know what you're trying to do with that.
You know, it all the time. Can 50 Cent do something without stirring up waters to catch fish? Do you have to always throw up water?
No. Look at Taraji. I told Taraji I want to work with her when you see the numbers come back. Mm-hmm. Because I never had, every time when I spoke to you, I sat right here on the show and I said, I don't have a problem with Taraji or Terrence. Mm-hmm. But the executives did steal from the market and the power. Mm-hmm. And that's what I meant then. Like, I never had no issue. The shows weren't on the air at the same time.
Right.
I was attaching myself to them through that. The argument in order to be connected to that marketing budget Fox was going to spend. You see the difference in ABC launch, right? You can't even watch the Oscars without watching this. Right. My favorite part of the Oscars was the commercials.